Good morning, everyone, and welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ASI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session without any delay. But before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon if you are coming here for the first time. And you can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session and its link you will find in the description. So let's talk about the very first question, which says Mines Ministry has adopted the scheme for accreditation of private exploration agencies for undertaking prospecting operation of minerals. Which of the following is not one of the benefits of this move? Now, who is the Minister of Mines? It's Mr. Prahlad Joshi. Prahlad Joshi is the Mines Minister and he is also the Minister of Coal and Parliamentary Affairs. Alright. So this ministry has adopted the scheme for accreditation of private exploration agencies. Now, what is the meaning of adoption here? Why a ministry is adopting a scheme? So, yahan pe iska matlab ye hai that the scheme has been developed by one organization and then the implementing responsibility of that particular scheme is now with the mines ministry. Iska matlab ye hai, matlab ek organization ne scheme ko formulate kiya aur ab isko implement karne ka kaam kiska hai? Mines ministry ka hai. To yahan pe adoption ka matlab yahi hai, isse zyada aur kuch nahi hai. So let's talk about the news. What is the news? So the Mines Ministry has adopted the scheme for accreditation of private exploration agencies who are undertaking the prospecting operation of minerals. And this has been done, of course, to increase the pace of exploration of minerals in the country and also to increase the efficiency of the exploration of minerals in the country. Now talking about the objective of this particular scheme, so to bring advanced technology in the exploration of minerals is one of the objectives. To bring more explored blocks for auction, to increase the pace of exploration, of course. It will create new employment opportunities, of course. If the pace of exploration increases, then of course there will be new employment opportunities and also the entrepreneurship opportunities as well. So it will encourage new entrepreneurs also. The scheme has been developed by National Accreditation Board for Education and Training, which is an organization of Quality Council of India, which is an arm of Quality Council of India. Do remember this name, National Accreditation Board for Education and Training, which is an arm of Quality Council of India. And what is the process? So this QCI NABARD will grant accreditation to the private exploration agencies for undertaking prospecting operations of minerals in accordance with the standards and procedures of the scheme. Is a scheme ki detail mein jaane ki koi zarurat nahi hai. There is no need to go into details of this scheme. Just remember that this scheme is being implemented by the Ministry of Mines. And the scheme has been developed by this board, which is known as National Accreditation Board for Education and Training. All right. So this was about this news, guys. And now, so the question is, which of the following is not one of the benefits? So it will bring more explored blocks for auction. Yes. It will increase pace of exploration. Yes. It will enhance the quality of minerals explored. Dekho, क्वालिटी ऑफ मिनरल्स की यहाँ पे कोई बात नहीं की गई है और जब तक कोई बात नहीं की जाएगी तब तक हम यही मानेंगे कि ये बात यहाँ पे नहीं की गई है तो इसलिए इस आंसर को हम गलत मानेंगे इस ऑप्शन को. इट विल एनकरेज द न्यू एंटरप्रेन्योर्स यस एंड इट विल आल्सो ब्रिंग एडवांस टेक्नोलॉजी इन एक्सप्लोरेशन ऑफ मिनरल्स विच मीन्स द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट ऑप्शन सी बिकॉज यहाँ पे दे हैव नॉट टॉक्ड अबाउट द एक्सप्लोरेशन ऑफ क्वालिटी ऑफ मिनरल्स एक्सप्लोर्ड राइट. So moving ahead, guys, to question number 2, which says, which of the following has launched the pilot run or soft launch of the International Bullion Exchange? I hope you all know the meaning of bullion. It is basically physical gold and silver. Gold and silver jo hota hai usko bullion bhi kaha jata hai. And ek naya International Bullion Exchange open hoga India mein as a pilot run. So the question is, which of the following organization has launched the pilot run or the soft launch of International Bullion Exchange? All right. इट विल बी एक्सचेंज जैसे कि हमारा एक स्टॉक मार्केट एक्सचेंज होता है उसी तरीके से सोने और चांदी के लिए भी एक्सचेंज होगा. इट विल बी लाइक द स्टॉक मार्केट एक्सचेंज वेयर स्टॉक्स आर ट्रेडेड. इन दिस एक्सचेंज द गोल्ड एंड सिल्वर विल बी ट्रेडेड राइट. सो दिस हैज बीन लॉन्च बाय IFSCA इंटरनेशनल फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज सेंट्रल अथॉरिटी एंड आई होप यू ऑल नो इट इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन गांधीनगर विच इज ऑफकोर्स इन गुजरात. एंड हु इज द चेयरपर्सन? इट्स मिस्टर इंजेति श्रीनिवास. Injethi Srinivas is the chairperson of IFSCA. So IFSCA has launched this International Bullion Exchange as a pilot launch. And bullion ka matlab I hope aap sabko pata hai. And for this CDSL IFSC will be the विल बी द बुलियन डिपोजिटरी, इट इज अ फॉरेन डिपोजिटरी, एक डिपोजिटरी चाहिए होता है जहां पे, जैसे हमारे एनएसडीएल और सीडीएसएल है, जैसे हम स्टॉक में ट्रेडिंग करते हैं तो जो हमारे स्टॉक्स होते हैं वो कहाँ जमा होते हैं, एनएसडीएल में, सीडीएसएल में. सो उसी तरीके से दिस सीडीएसएल और एफएससी विच इज अ फॉरेन डिपोजिटरी विल बी विल एक्ट एज द डिपोजिटरी फॉर दिस एक्सचेंज विच इज नोन एज इंटरनेशनल बुलियन एक्सचेंज एंड इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय आईएफएससी, राइट, एंड इट विल बी लाइव, इट विल गो लाइव ऑन 1st of October 2021 विच इज द फाउंडेशन डे ऑफ आईएफएससी. ओके, इसमें इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा पढ़ने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. सो द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन गाइज इज वॉट, द आईएफएससी, इंटरनेशनल फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज सेंटर्स अथॉरिटी. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, व्हाट इज किगाली अमेंडमेंट फॉर. ये क्वेश्चन आपको पता होना चाहिए, इसका आंसर आपको आना चाहिए. इफ यू ऑल नो, इफ यू रिमेंबर द मॉन्ट्रियल प्रोटोकॉल, व्हाट इज द मॉन्ट्रियल प्रोटोकॉल, इट इज फॉर, इट वॉज, it was a protocol for removing the ozone depleting substances from the environment, and under this protocol there was an amendment which is known as Kigali amendment, or they also say it Kigali agreement also. theek hai, to Kigali amendment hua tha for the removal of hydrofluorocarbon, yes, for the removal of hydrofluorocarbons from the environment, or you can say to cut down the production and consumption of the hydrofluorocarbon from the environment. So let's talk about ki ye news mein kyun hai, because recently the Union Cabinet has approved the ratification of Kigali Amendment under the Montreal Protocol. It was adopted by the parties to the Montreal Protocol in month of October 2016, which was during the 28th meeting of the parties to the Montreal Protocol, which was held at Kigali. Now can you tell me where is this place Kigali? If you do not know the answer, तो आपको मैं अगली क्लास में बता दूंगा. Can you tell me where is this place? Kigali. Kigali कहाँ पे? Kigali of course is a place जहाँ पे ये 28th meeting हुई थी Montreal Protocol की, parties to the Montreal Protocol की, और उसी के नाम पे वो agreement है, उसी के नाम पे amendment है. Montreal of course is also a place. So Kigali आपको बताना है कि कहाँ पे है. And the cabinet has approved the ratification of Kigali agreement. Cabinet मतलब India का cabinet, Union Cabinet of India, right? And of course, this has been done to cut down the production and consumption of the hydrofluorocarbons from the environment. And if you all know, hydrofluorocarbons are the refrigerants which are used in air conditioners, refrigerators, aerosols, sprayers, etc. Or ye ek ozone depleting substance hai. Now talking about the Kigali Agreement. So as I told you, it is an amendment to the Montreal Protocol. And Montreal Protocol is a protocol for removing the ozone depleting substances from the environment, and this was the 8th amendment. The Kigali amendment was the 8th amendment in this Montreal protocol. 197 member countries has signed the agreement to amend the Montreal protocol that time, aur India ne ab usko ratification ki manzoori de di hai Union Cabinet ne. And remember, Kigali amendment and Kigali agreement are the same thing, okay, there is no difference. And remember guys, according to the terms of the Kigali Amendment, the signing country, jo bhi country sign karegi, that country is expected to decrease the manufacture and usage of HFCs by about 80-85% from their baseline to up to 2045. Jo bhi unka baseline hai, 2045 tak unko us baseline se 80-85% production and consumption of HFCs ko reduce karna hai. And HFCs, you all know, this will curb global warming by arresting global average temperature rise to 0.5 degree Celsius by the year 2100. India will complete its phase down of HFCs in 4 steps, starting from 2032, and 10% in 2032 reduction, then 20% in 2037, 30% in 2042, and 80% in 2047. So these are the targets which have been set by the government of India under the Kigali Amendment or the Kigali Agreement. Alright. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. So what is Kigali Amendment for? Okay, to increase the maximum, no, to phase down the production and consumption of hydrofluorocarbon. Yes. So option B, guys, is the correct answer to this question, to phase down the production and consumption of hydrofluorocarbons. I hope guys this news is clear, and now let's move ahead to question number 4. Ab is wale question mein you just have to remember that 3 online application has been launched by the Ministry of Science and Technology and just the name of these on an application. उससे ज्यादा डिटेल में जाने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है बिकॉज दैट विल बी टू टेक्निकल फॉर अस. थ्री ऑनलाइन एप्लीकेशंस वर इनॉग्रेटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी हेडेड बाय डॉक्टर जितेंद्र सिंह. डॉक्टर जितेंद्र सिंह लोकसभा कंस्टिट्यूएंसी उधमपुर इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. एंड दीज ऑनलाइन एप्लीकेशंस आर फॉर मेकिंग जियो स्पेशल डेटा कलेक्टेड बाय गवर्नमेंट फ्रीली एंड ईजिली अवेलेबल टू द सिटीजन्स एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन इंडिया फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम. Among the following which is not one of them, इनमें से कौन सा एक उनमें से नहीं है. तो तीन लॉन्च हुई थी उनमें से एक ये, इनमें से कोई एक नहीं है. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द न्यूज. सो दीज आर द थ्री ऑनलाइन एप्लीकेशंस दैट हैव बीन लॉन्च बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. नंबर वन इज सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया जियो स्पेशल डेटा डिसमिनेशन पोर्टल. एंड आई होप यू ऑल नो दैट सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया इज द ओल्डेस्ट साइंटिफिक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ आवर कंट्री. Oldest scientific organization of India is Survey of India, and it was established in the year 1767 by, of course, East India Company. Number two is SOI's Sarthi. SOI means Survey of India Sarthi web GIS application. And then we have Manchitran, which is an enterprise geo portal of NATMO, and NATMO stands for National Atlas and Thematic Mapping Organization. Okay. ये तीन एप्लीकेशंस हैं जो लॉन्च की गई हैं बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. एंड दिस हैज बीन डन फॉर मेकिंग जियो स्पेशल डेटा कलेक्टेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट. और ये जो डेटा होगा दैट विल बी अवेलेबल टू द सिटीजंस एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस एब्सोल्युटली फ्री थ्रू दीज. ऑफकोर्स दिस विल बी अवेलेबल थ्रू दीज वेब एप्लीकेशंस दैट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड. थोड़ी सी बात कर लेते हैं. सबसे पहले अगर SOI जियो स्पेशल डेटा डिसेमिनेशन पोर्टल की बात करें, सो इट विल provide a range of digital products like what? Like digital geographical map, railway map, political map. Okay. Moving ahead to another application which is SOI Sarthi. So it will utilize the new advancements in web application development with GIS technology like spatial data visualization, and it will help in manipulation and analysis to the user with the less utilization of resources at the client's end. Basically, yeah. काफी टेक्निकल है. यू डोंट हैव टू डू ऑल दीज थिंग्स. ये मैंने बट इसमें लिख दिया है ताकि आपको बेसिक आइडिया रहे कि ये क्या है. एंड देन वी हैव मानचित्रन विच इज बेसिकली अ पोर्टल ऑफ NATMO. इट विल शोकेस द वैल्यूएबल डेटा दैट NATMO हैज अक्वायर्ड ड्यूरिंग इट्स 65 ईयर ऑफ सर्विस. ओके, इसमें से ज्यादा पढ़ने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है. अब वापस आ जाओ क्वेश्चन पे. So which of the following is not one of them? Geospatial data dissemination portal hai Sarthi. Priyavekshak nahi hai. So option C3 will be the correct answer guys to this question. And moving ahead to question number 5, which is guys very important for the NABARD exam, kyunki ye fourth advanced estimate ke upar based hai question. So the question is, which statement is not correct according to the fourth advanced estimate of production of major agricultural crops for the year 2020-21 released by the Department of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. So there is was, according to this estimate guys, the food production has record, matlab usne ek record darj kiya hai, a record 308.65 million tons of food grains have been produced according to the fourth advanced estimate of the year 2020-21. Okay, record hai number yaad rakhna 208.65 million tons, and it is higher by 11.14 million tons than the production of food grain during the year 2019-20 jo 2019-20 mein tha usse 11.4 million tons high hai. The production during 2020-21 is higher by 29.77 million tons than the previous 5 years. That is from financial year 2016 to financial year 2020. Now, अलग अलग food grain की अगर हम बात करें तो उनमें ये production हुआ है. Total food grain production है कितना 308.65 million ton, which is a record. And out of this 308.65 million, rice 122.27, which is again a record. Wheat 109.52, which is again a record. तो सारा मत याद करना, but जहाँ पे record production हुई है that you should remember. सिमिलरली ऑयल सी प्रोडक्शन में 36.10 मिलियन टन्स, विच इज अगेन अ रिकॉर्ड प्रोडक्शन. शुगर केन प्रोडक्शन 399.25 मिलियन टन्स. कॉटन प्रोडक्शन 35.38 मिलियन बेल्स ऑफ 170 केजी ईच. एंड जूट एंड वेस्ट प्रोडक्शन 9.56 मिलियन बेल्स। सो इसमें से आपको क्या क्या याद रखना है टेबल में, जो रिकॉर्ड वाली चीजें हैं एटलीस्ट उतना तो याद रख लो, ठीक है। ये चार चीजें तो बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है, यू शुड रिमेंबर ऑल दीज फोर, ओके। एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन, यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट। अ रिकॉर्ड 408.65 मिलियन टन्स ऑफ फूड, नहीं ये पहला ही वाला स्टेटमेंट गलत है, इट इज नॉट 408.65, इट इज 308.65, और ये सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट नंबर है आउट ऑफ ऑल द नंबर्स दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन दिस न्यूज। 308.65 मिलियन टन्स का है प्रोडक्शन, फूड प्रोडक्शन इन द ईयर 2020-21 अकॉर्डिंग टू द फोर्थ एडवांस एस्टिमेट। So therefore the correct answer will be option A because this is the incorrect statement. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.